Hello, I'm Andrews, and I will be talking about Apache Cayenne 4.1. As the name implies, Cayenne is a part of the family of the Apache Software Foundation projects, and Cayenne is an ORM. An ORM stands for object-relational mapping. This simply means a technology that connects your object world to the database world, and it generates SQL for queries to get objects out of the database, and vice versa. When you take a graph of objects and you want to save them in a database, it will generate SQL for you to do it efficiently and with just one method call. Apache Cayenne 4.1 release was posted just a couple of days ago, and this is a major milestone that has 56 new features and 127 bug fixes. I'm not going to discuss each one of them individually. Instead, I identified three main areas of improvement in Cayenne, and I'm going to demo them right now. The first one is the fact that Cayenne is practically dependency-free now. I'm saying practically because there's still an SLF4j API login breach that is still a dependency, which is a small, non-invasive library, and you probably know about it. But the good thing, it does not depend on anything like commons collections or commons lang or any bytecode enhancement libraries. Let me show you that quickly. So here's my project, and I have a dependency on Apache Cayenne. I have a dependency on the JDBC driver. Let's see what Cayenne brings into the project. So if you look at Cayenne dependencies, it's only SLF4j and Cayenne DI, which is also part of Cayenne, so it's on the same version, and that's it. There's nothing else. The second new feature is the ability to do DB import using Cayenne modeler. So you can do the entire Cayenne mapping workflow from the GUI tool. Let me show you how that works. I'm starting the modeler, and I select my demo project and select data map and go to DB import tab. The first thing you usually need is to configure the database connection, so that's your local database that you will import your schema from. I already have one. And now I can click refresh. And you see I got a list of tables in a database called HR and CRM. And this database intentionally mixes tables from two different domains so that I can show you how to select just a subset of tables. And the simplest way to do it is to just drag and drop them to the left side panel. But that's not very scalable. We can potentially have hundreds of these HR tables. So let me delete those and instead create a pattern. So the table name is a pattern, so you can match table names that start with HR underscore and then continue with any symbols and end with a dollar sign. As you see, I need to match the entire string. Now I can click Run Import. As you see, these two tables are imported and object entities are created for them, HR employee and HR employee salary. Let's improve this a bit. We don't need the object entities to start with HR. So let me delete that and go to advanced options and specify another pattern. I would like to strip from the table names the prefix HR underscore. Okay, once this is done, we can rerun the import again. And as you can see, the object entity names are now correct. Let me save all of this. And your configuration is saved now, so the next time you go there or somebody else goes there, they will get the same configuration so they can rerun the import. The next step in Cayenne workflow is class generation. So once you have your model, you click class generation tab, and you will need to select output directory. Usually Cayenne pre-populates that for you based on the known project structures, like Maven projects, for instance. But if this looks wrong, you can select your own directory and then click Generate. Let's save this. and go back to idea, and as you see, it created pairs of classes for the entities employee, employee salary, with underscore as a superclasses, and employee and employee salary without underscore are the subclasses that you will use in your project. And we will take a look at the superclass shortly. The important part of this whole DB import flow is that it can be repeated any number of times. Say we have a change in the database. So I have some SQL that creates a new table and alters the existing tables. So let me run that. Go back to Cayenne modeler, and under DB import tab, click refresh again. As you see, the new table HR address is there, and since we used the pattern, we don't need to change anything in our configuration. We can just rerun the import, and all the new changes are imported and merged into our model. So this process can be run incrementally as your schema changes. So let's take a look here. So the address entity is there, and the new relationships are there. So everything was merged properly. Let's go to class generation and regenerate the classes again and save. And come back to idea, and you see the address was generated, and it's now part of the project. And finally, the third new feature, which is field-based data objects. In the past, data objects internally were storing their values in maps. And this was a dynamic and fairly practical way of doing it, but it incurred a performance hit, because maps are more expensive to read and write from than simple object fields. So let's take a look how the new data object look like. So here I have an employee subclass that I've already shown. Let's go to the superclass and see what's in the superclass. So in generated superclass, you see all the stuff that was there previously in Cayenne 4.0, the properties, right? Those are the things that help you to build queries and so on. So as you see, all the properties are generated as fields. So compared to the 4.0 map style of data objects, this saves you a lot of memory. In some of our tests, the savings were up to 50%, but of course that varies on the structure, depending on the structure of your data objects. And less memory means a couple of things. First of all, it means, you know, less money that you pay to Amazon. And second, it means faster garbage collection, so faster overall performance, because now Java only needs to deal with 50% of garbage compared to 4.0. So you get this performance boost automatically after upgrading. And we still preserved the dynamic map-based data objects, because they're useful when you want to create certain persistent properties dynamically. But the default right now is field-based. Okay, so these were the new features in Apache Cayenne 4.1. I hope you liked what you saw, and these things bring you immediate benefits, and 4.1 is definitely an important upgrade for you. It is published on Maven Central, so you can start using it right away. And for the modeler, you need to go to cayenne.apache.org and download it. Thank you. Enjoy using Cayenne.